Hello students, in this video I have given some questions on quantitative analysis. You can find one more questions on volumetric and gravimetric analysis, students. Hope these questions help you, and just go through once all these questions. These are only just for your reference. Okay students, let's start. First question, what is a primary standard substance? It is a substance of high purity and known concentration, that is it is dissolved in a known volume of the solvent to give a primary standard solution. Okay, so with this primary standard substance we can prepare a primary standard solution, and also students its concentration doesn't change on long standing. And also primary standard substances are the reagents which involve in the reactions, and they are often used to know or to determine the unknown concentration of a solution that can undergo a chemical reaction with the primary standard. Okay, so the solutions are there are few substances, students, which are called as secondary substances, and the secondary standard solutions, their concentration changes on time. So in order to determine the concentration of secondary standard solutions, we use generally primary standard solutions. Okay, when you are asked what a primary standard substance means, you should be able to write that it is of high purity and known concentration. Okay, immediately comes the second question. What is a secondary standard substance? So it is the one which has less purity than a primary standard substance. These are less stable, and also they are chemically reactive than the primary standard substances. Okay, and the third question, few examples for primary standard substances. Here I have given few, like sodium carbonate, magnesium sulfate, sodium oxalate, oxalic acid, and also potassium dichromate, etc. Okay, and next comes the question, give some examples for secondary standard substances. Like we have hypo-EDTA, sodium hydroxide, HCl, etc. These are few examples for secondary standard substances. Next question, how many types of standard solutions? Yes, there are two types, primary and secondary. Next, what is a primary standard solution? These are the solutions which are made from primary standard substances and are with high purity and less reactivity, as we have seen earlier. Next, secondary standard solution means which is not pure and is chemically reactive than a primary standard solution. Next, what is molarity? It is the concentration of a solution which can be expressed as number of moles of solute in 1 liter solution. Okay, next question, how do we calculate molarity? So molarity can be calculated like this, students. Moles of solute by liters of solution. So number of moles, how do we get? By weight by molecular weight. So weight by molecular weight into liter, we can use this formula to calculate molarity. Next, what is an acid-base titration? It is the method of quantitative chemical analysis which is used for determining concentration of an acid or a base by exactly neutralizing it with a standard solution of base or acid having known concentration. Okay, next, what is an indicator? It is the substance which is used in the titrations in order to know the completion of a chemical reaction. So how do we know that a chemical reaction is completed? It can be known by the change in color. So okay, so this change in color can be noticed by the usage of an indicator. Okay, next, what is meant by a complexometric titration? So these are the titrations in which the formation of a colored complex is used to indicate the end point of a titration. Students, generally in complexometric titrations, we notice the formation of complexes which are colored. Next, what is the formula of sodium bicarbonate, NaHCO3? Next, expand EDTA. EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. Next question, what is the end point in the estimation of sodium carbonate? Yellow to pink. Next, hardness of water is expressed in parts per million. Next, the other name for acid-based titrations, they are also called as neutralization titrations. The indicator generally used in complexometric titrations, EBT, which is called as eriochrome black tea. Next, what is the molecular weight of sodium carbonate? It is 106. What is the indicator which is used in estimation of sodium carbonate? It is a methyl orange. Next question, what is the primary standard substance used in complexometric titrations? Generally, this is the first step in the procedure, students. We prepare a standard solution of magnesium sulfate, so which is the primary standard substance. Next, formula of sodium oxalate, Na2C2O4. Next, what is the primary standard substance used in estimation of acetic acid in vinegar, oxalic acid? Okay, you were asked the formula for oxalic acid, it is H2C2O4. It's a dicarboxylic acid, students. Next, estimation of acetic acid in vinegar is an example of acid-base titrations. Next, hardness of water is generally expressed in terms of equivalent amounts of calcium carbonate. Next question, hardness of water is generally due to the presence of calcium and magnesium ions. Next, students, the sodium carbonate reacts with hydrogen chloride in HCl in two stages. The first stage, where sodium carbonate is converted into sodium bicarbonate, is called as, it is called as semi-neutralization or half neutralization. Next, what is the secondary standard substance used in the estimation of sodium carbonate? That is HCl. So this is generally, students, the second step in the procedure, standardization of HCl. So this is of unknown concentration, for which we use standard Na2CO3. Next question, calculate the molarity of MgSO4 using the given data. So here you are given, students, molarity of EDTA, volume of EDTA, number of moles of EDTA, volume of MgSO4, number of moles of MgSO4. Okay, so you can just denote the molarity of EDTA. All the values of EDTA you can use as M1, V1, N1, and MgSO4 values you can denote them by M2, V2, and N2. Okay, so we have the formula M1 V1 by N1 is equal to M2 V2 by N2. So molarity of MgSO4, we have taken it as M2. So M2 is equal to M1 V1 N2 by N1 V2. If you substitute all the values and calculate, you will get 0.05 m. Next, calculate the molarity of 1.325 grams of sodium carbonate is dissolved in distilled water and made up to the volume in a 250 ml standard flask. Okay, so here you can use the formula, students, weight by liter into molecular weight. So it is taken in a 250 ml standard flask. So you can substitute weight as 1.325 and molecular weight of sodium carbonate, you know it is 106, and it is 250 ml, so you can take it as weight by molecular weight into, what do you do? So generally, in the first step, while calculating the molarity of the first step, we use generally this formula, that is W2 minus W3 by 106 into 1000 by 250. So here W2 minus W3 means weight of sodium carbonate. So here weight is given how much, students? 1.325. Okay. So if you calculate 1.325 by 106 into 1000 by 250, then you will get the answer as 0.05 capital M molar. Next, what is the formula of oxalic acid? H2C2O4. So next, what is the end point in the estimation of acetic acid in vinegar? Colorless to pink. What is the secondary standard substance in estimation of acetic acid in vinegar? Sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH. Next, one more problem, students. Here also, like the previous one, you can use the formula M1V1 by N1 equals to M2V2 by N2. If you calculate, you will get the concentration of NaOH as 0.1 m. Next, the end point in half neutralization of Na2CO3 can be detected using the indicator phenolphthalein. What is the end point in estimation of sodium bicarbonate? Yellow to pink. Next, what is the second step in the procedure of estimation of Mg+2 ions in the given solution? Standardization of EDTA. EDTA is the secondary standard substance. Next, what is the end point in estimation of Mg+2 ions in the given solution? It is pink to blue. Why is ammonical buffer used in complexometric titrations, that is EDTA titrations? You know, students, this is used in order to maintain pH of the solution throughout the complete reaction and also for the formation of the metal EDTA complex. Next question, what is the principle involved in estimation of acetic acid in vinegar? So if you read the principle from the experiment, you will get this answer, students. Kindly go through the experiment. Next, what is the secondary standard substance in estimation of hardness of water? Here also it is EDTA. Next, what is generally quantitative analysis? It is determination of amount of one or more constituents of a compound or substance or a sample. Okay, so in qualitative analysis is identification of the constituents. Here quantitative means we are finding out the amount of the constituents, students. Okay, next, what is meant by volumetric analysis? So the amount of the substance is determined by measuring the volume, then it is called as volumetric analysis. Next, methyl orange indicator gives which color in basic medium? So it gives yellow color in basic medium and red color in acidic medium. Next, in acidic medium, phenolphthalein is colorless, and in basic medium, it gives pink color. Next, in order to neutralize one mole of sodium carbonate, how many moles of HCl are required? We require 2 moles of HCl. So, 1 mole of Na2CO3 can be neutralized by 2 moles of HCl. Okay. So, the reaction goes like this, students. Na2CO3 plus 2 HCl gives 2 NaCl plus H2O plus CO2. Next, one more problem again. You can use the formula and calculate. Next, what is the pH of ammonical buffer? It ranges from 9 to 11. Next question, estimation of hardness of water and Mg+2 ions are the examples of complexometric titrations. We have these two experiments under complexometric titrations. Next, EBT, that is eriochrome black tea, which has blue color, this on addition with Mg+2 ions, what is formed? A red colored complex is being formed. Next, what is the molecular weight of oxalic acid? It is 126. Next, when EDTA reacts with Mg+2 ions, a colored complex is formed whose structure is octahedral. Next question, the primary standard substance in dichrometry, K2Cr2O7. Next, molecular weight of K2Cr2O7, 294.18. Next question, students, what is the indicator which is used in dichrometry? Sodium diphenylamine sulfonate. What is the formula of potassium dichromate? K2Cr2O7. Next, hypo is also called as sodium thiosulfate. What is the indicator that is used in idiometric titrations? Starch. What is the secondary standard substance in idiometry? Hypo. Next, what is the primary standard substance used in permanganometry? Sodium oxalate. KMnO4 can act as self-indicator, true or false? Yes, it can act as self-indicator. What is the formula of sodium oxalate? Na2C2O4. Next, what is the indicator used in precipitation titrations? Diphenyl benzidine. Next, nickel can be estimated using DMG, which is called as dimethyl glyoxime. One more numerical, students. Next, what is the endpoint in the estimation of Fe+2 ions, that is ferrous ions, by dichrometry? Blue color. Appearance of blue color. Next, give an example for iodometric titrations. Estimation of copper ions, that is U+2 ions. Next, you can, the question can also be asked like this, students. Complete the following reaction. So you should be able to write the products. Next, calculate molarity of copper ions using the following set of values. So here also you will use the formula M1V1 by N1 equals to M2V2 by N2. Okay, see here, molarity of hypo is given, volume of hypo is given, number of moles of hypo is given. Volume of CuSO4, number of moles of Cu+2, and you should calculate molarity of Cu+2 ions. So that is 0.15 m. Next, in a titration, endpoint can be determined by change in color using an indicator. And next, students, in a colored solution which is taken in the burette, generally which meniscus is taken into consideration? So colored solutions, we read the upper meniscus, students. So please do remember this. Colorless solutions, we read lower meniscus. Colored solutions, we read upper meniscus. So the next question is also the same, taking into consideration KMnO4. KMnO4 is a colored solution, hence we read upper meniscus. Next example of primary standard solutions, hypopotassium dichromate, potassium permanganate, HCl. Rest all are secondary standard solutions. So B, that is potassium dichromate, is the primary standard solution. Next, the process of adding one solution from the burette to another in the titration flask in order to complete the chemical reaction involved is known as, it is called as titration. Next, another numerical, students. Next, estimation of nickel comes under gravimetric analysis. So here, determination of amount of the constituents by weighing the substance is called as gravimetric analysis. What is the color of the precipitate formed when nickel is reacted with dimethyl glyoxime? It is scarlet precipitate. What is the indicator which is used in estimation of Zn+2 ions? Diphenyl benzidine. What is the secondary standard substance in estimation of Zn+2 ions? Potassium ferrocyanide, K4FeCN6. What is the end point in estimation of Zn+2 ions? Blue to pale green. What is the primary standard substance used in estimation of Zn+2 ions? Zinc sulfate. The oxidation state of chromium in potassium dichromate, K2CR2O7, it is +6. What is the secondary standard substance in estimation of sodium oxalate? It is KMnO4, potassium permanganate. What is the end point in estimation of sodium oxalate? Appearance of pink color. What is the principle involved in estimation of sodium oxalate? Next question, what is the end point in the estimation of Cu+2 ions? It is disappearance of violet color. Next, when Ki is added to a solution of copper sulfate, which gas is liberated? It is iodine. Next, molecular weight of potassium dichromate, 294.18. What is the indicator that is used in dichrometric titrations? Sodium diphenylamine sulfonate. What is gravimetry? See here, I have given the definition, students. The amount of a given constituent or ion in a substance is determined in gravimetric analysis from the results of weighing. So here we weigh the substance. In volumetric analysis, we will know the amount of the substance by measuring the volume. Next, what is meant by titration? It is the process of adding one solution from the burette to another solution which is taken in the conical flask in order to complete the chemical reaction. So out of these solutions, one is standard, students. One must be standard, that is of known concentration. What are the two classes of quantitative analysis, volumetric and gravimetric? What is meant by a self indicator? It is basically the substance, chemical substance, which along with the self participation in the reaction, that means it involves in the reaction as well as it helps to indicate the end point of a titration. Expand DMG, it is dimethyl glyoxime. Next, why do we use freshly prepared starch solution in idiometric titrations? Because starch can undergo a photochemical reaction, and as time passes, it can undergo photochemical reaction and it would not be starch, but it might have changed into some other product. Okay, so as soon as we prepared a starch solution, we need to use it. Next, what is a titrant? It is the reagent of known concentration. What is a titrate? The substance being titrated is called as a titrate. Next, potassium dichromate, it is an oxidizing reagent. So what did you understand, students, after listening or after going through all these questions? So if you read all the experiments, then you can easily answer the questions given to you, whatever the question is asked. Okay, so please go through all the questions. I think one or two questions they might they are repeated, no worries. Okay, but go through, students, like this can be useful for your viva at least. So students, thank you for listening and all the best for your exams.